momentum from that water coming back will spill out the top, alright? Back to pressure situation, if we have back pressure against this line, it would tend to keep that part open, and just whatever the damage, the leaking we have down the line, it didn't come back, alright? So, it's for backside when you don't, alright? So, it's a bacteria, give a backside dose, only not testing. One of the few devices that we do not, it does not have test ports on. So, it's a visual inspection more of it than anything, but not really looking at much. It is, atmospheric vacuum breakers are on water closets. This is an atmospheric vacuum breaker on this. Connection there to wall, actually have a screw on the atmospheric vacuum breaker. With a atmospheric vacuum breaker, we cannot have any shut-off valve downstream. Okay? Atmospheric vacuum breakers are not supposed to be in service for more than 6 hours continuously. Okay? The reason being that plug comes up, it stick and not open up when a vacuum breaker is occurred. After 6 hours, that's kind of breaking. So, turn it off, drain the system down, and then fire it back up and do it. Alright, so if you have a shut-off valve downstream of an atmospheric vacuum breaker, then you could have it under pressure for a longer period, causing that sticking to occur as you're trying to prevent that. Good sticking to fail under pressure, it's good for gluten, orange, and ham. Alright, it's good for both. Critical level. Critical level on the device is the minimal elevation of the flood level rim or the receptacle of where the device is. Now, critical level is measured on if it's the device itself, then it is flow and out. So this is one, this is two, shut off valve. Shut off valve one, shut off valve two. We have two test cups, right? Direction of flow, test cup one, test cup two. Okay. So remember that, and you'll get comfortable when you start seeing them. But remember, direction of flow and how it goes. All right, good for back cycling. Generally testable, good for fluid dynamics. Internally loaded valve, but can be elevated pressure and can have shut-off valve downstream. In fact, I've got a shut-off valve built into it. Critical level for this is 12 inches. It's higher than an atmospheric vacuum level. All right, so anything downstream, that needs 12 inches above it. Most of these do have a CO marking or a critical level marking on the device themselves, but if it's not marked, then you consider the bottom of the device critical level. Right? Double check valve assembly. Right? Double check valve assembly is two independent acting check valves in a line. Alright, so normal flow comes through shut off valve one, opens up shut off valve two,
he's done it a couple times, I think, for four.
Instructor. I thought you were talking about
Ford. No, he was an instructor.
Or, cops on this bus. If a back driving incident occurs, right, if I'm pulling on this, take out one set of clothes and then take out the other clothes as well. Got siphoning or a back pressure event occurs, and pushing from the out of the end, and I can push this thing. That's the pressure that push the clothes with clothes two and clothes one. Okay. Alright, so good for back siphoning and back pressure. But it's good for polluting on. Alright, what is it? Right. So for polluting on. With that in mind, we'll talk about why it's polluting on in a little bit. Alright. It is testable. It has two identical check valves. Two identical check valves. Check down one, check down two, are both internally loaded the same. So we go to repair one of these or work on one of these, we take it apart, we can interchange. Check down one, check down two. Right. So it does not matter. They are identical. Internally loaded, they do operate independently from one another. So, sink and disc are the primary sealing components. Alright, our big fan daddy favorite is our RPPA or RPZ and RP, the big fresh principal assembly or the big fresh zone. It is our RPZ. Alright, so in operation, through normal flow, water coming in. That's our shut-off valve, water comes in. To our reduced pressure zone. Right? It's going to seal that reduced pressure zone. Right? This is actually a relief similar to the relief on our pressure vacuum breakers and our atmospheric vacuum breakers. Water will spill out of this zone. The water comes in, seals that zone, shuts it up. Right? If it is allowed to build up and seal that zone, then water will continue on. And open check valve one. Okay. Once it opens check valve one, it flows on and sees that that zone is sealed on the other side. Now we check both sides of that check valve. Okay. So if the zone is stable, then the water will flow by, open check valve two. And then flow out. Okay? If we have a back pressure occurs, back pressure is going to be pushing against this check valve. This check valve is going to close. When that check valve closes, it's going to change the pressure in that zone. When it changes the pressure in that zone, it's going to cause that zone to open. It's going to start spilling out water. The water is going to spill out and check valve one will close as well. So they can fill that water and both check valve will end up closing. Just in reverse, if it's back side of this, check valve one is going to close, the zone is going to open, it's going to notice if check valve one doesn't close automatically, it's going to notice that pressure difference in the zone itself by it spilling out and it will close. Check valve one, and then check valve two will close again. They're not spilling out on the ground. They're spilling out on the ground. I like the engine. All right, so reduced pressure principle assembly, RP and RPV. Good for back cycling and back pressure. It is the mechanical equivalent to an air gap. So, air gets our best all around way. This is our best all around mechanical way. Alright, so we can't do an air gap. This is gonna make the best possible. For witness and contaminants, both. It is testable as two check valves, but check valve one is loaded 2 PSI greater than check valve two. There is a difference between those check valves, a 2 PSI difference. You will take one of these apart, and you will be able to feel the difference in the pressure of the springs themselves that load these valves. So we cannot interchange check valve one and check valve two because of the loading is different. Does that relief valve, which is actually this pressure zone, is on the test. Discharges the water when the pressure difference between check valve one and check valve two is realized. If there is a pressure difference between the two check valves, then that zone is open. So when that zone opens, it's still in that water and closing check valve. So the check valve will close. Air gap requires that physical separation. So if you cannot physically separate the incoming water from the faucet, so you're going to hook directly to the machine. So you got water coming in, going through that RPZ, and then just past that RPZ, you're adding a coolant. That coolant needs to add with that water to cool that machine process while it's doing. Okay? So you can't, unless you put water into a vat, it receives the coolant and then pump out of that vat to go through that. So
air bag is the most simple way to one stage done. That is where the RPZ is the temperature holding stage.
Well, the air gap is more for filling the vessel. You're gonna fill a tank.
And that's all it is.
And you're gonna fill that tank, and when the tank is too low, it's gonna open back up and fill. So you got a float system on it, shut off valve. Keep that tank at such low. So if you're using out of that tank, then you can fill it with an air gap to fill it and have that air gap so you're not connected to the water. But if you have a machine that runs constant and needs one pressure from the water and introduces another chemical, then that constant that direct connection. Now the direct connection is a physical arrangement of the pipes that's connected to it all the time. So non-potable and non-potable. The non-potable is the machine itself, whether the process is doing, anything that's added to that water, make that machine do its process, that'd be a non-potable. So that makes that cross connection. So to have water to it all the time, then we need that RPZ in there and permanent physical arrangement of it. So in a direct connection.
Pretty much when you have constant pressure, you need the RP.
Well, yeah, you could, if you use out of that and pump system.
Yeah,
the main reason that we use any backflow prevention device is to protect the bottle side. So, what has happened, and my favorite book is Backflow flow is over you. And this is not a stream yet, but the very first one that been decided in the book, 1908. So I've been working on it for a while.
Yeah, go on.
So the last one, and these are incidents that have been, the last one is 2009, and these are reported incidents.
Yeah.
There's many that happened that ain't got in, you know, they're taken care of and haven't been in that book. There's one incident that's in the book is, they started noticing in the factory people were starting to get sick. And we're getting sick in relation to the distance they were from a water plant. Okay? What had happened was, water came in, went to the fashion area, water fountain outside of it, and if you were closer to the water fountain, you would get sick. Farther you away, then you would get sick. They branched into that line and tied it to the machine. So whoever was drinking out of that water fountain, but that, whenever they use that water fountain, a little bit of that stuff come from that machine back into that line before they realize what they did and put a black hole device in. So after they figured out all the fighting, they said, all right, you did it wrong. So, so they put a black hole device in. So incidents like that have occurred. At one point, license moves here in Louisville, that their water coming in to hose down the burden. Didn't have back load device on it, and it was actually something that was junk back in the back. So, yeah. Some of those are not reported. Some of these events taken care of and don't make it into the vehicle. But they do occur. They're events that occur all the time. These are serious that have to be. World Fair was one of them. Back in Chicago, way back in they had a bad connection between sewer and fresh water, and it was one back in the time. And, you know, a lot of people said that in the World Fair. Many, many of them. That's what we're trying to do. So we're trying to make sure that if we tie into anything, that what device we're going to, if is it going to be, you know, just a bathroom where you know, we don't have anything that is flexible coming back into that, we have our protection in place, or is it a machine that's going to have that cooling liquid added to the system, then we've got to do that, so we need that device there. Or generally, for all factories and all businesses, they will have any business pretty much anymore, will have an RPZ as soon as the water comes in. A meter, an RPZ, and then goes out to that inside that building. That RPZ is our best mechanical means. So it's going to protect anything from inside that building. And going back to the number. Once we get inside the building, right, so Lauren's got four connections to the truck right now, to the main, I believe. I know LAP's got three, I think y'all have four. They might have been adding a fourth one too. Anyway, so outside, bottled water that's coming off Old Main is gonna have an RPD. Then it's gonna get into the building. Once it gets into the building, you're gonna have 20 to 40 on RPD. RPDs throughout the plant. Whatever you got water flowing into a bath, typically they go ahead and put an RPD. You don't have a trash bin, or you got a water hookup to a hose, you spray stuff out. You got a pressure vacuum breaker there. Okay, preventing anything from that hose from going back into the bottle system. Probably won't have any double check valve.